If you're like most businesses, you have a very distinct way that you want to present yourself. You've worked hard on a specific type of branding, a look and feel that represents your organization. Well, a lot of the time, you might feel like you're hitting a roadblock when it comes to building custom applications because you want to keep that branding, you want to keep the look and feel of your organization, but you just don't have the option. Well, thanks to Softr's customization tools, you can actually build the look and feel of your web application in no code so simply. And that is exactly what I'm going to be breaking down for you in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you to get the most out of your no-code tools. And Softr is one of our favorite no-code tools, especially for that front-end component building that web application. And that's exactly what we're going to be talking about here today. Before I get into the heart of things, though, I first want to invite you to follow along with me in your own Softr account. If you don't already have one set up, you can go ahead and start a free trial using the link that I'll share in this video. Now, without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. And here I am inside of Softr. I have actually already created the template that I want to be working with here, but you can follow along quickly by simply installing it yourself. Go to create a new application, and I'm using the internal tools, and I've installed the project tracker. Now on the back end, I created the data schema for this in Airtable. I just copied it right out of Softr. And on the front end, of course, I'm using Softr. Now, just in case Softr is a brand new tool for you and you have no idea what we're talking about, let me first describe what Softr is. It is an amazing software tool that does not require any code, hence the no code, and you can build your own custom applications with this software. So wherever your data lives, if it's in Google Sheets, Airtable, HubSpot, or some other data source, there's a great chance that you can just build your application how you want people to interact with your data using Softr. They can log in and have their own unique experience based on the role that they have, what you want them to see, what you want them to be able to edit, add, delete. You have full capacity, full control over what your users experience with your data. But as we mentioned in the whole point of this video, we've got to talk about how you customize the look and feel of it. So once you've installed that project tracker, then you will have something very similar to this on your back end. Now, this is the data that was created by Softr when I installed the template, and we've got four different components here. We have teams, projects, we have tasks, and lastly, we have task comments. So all of this information is relating to the application that we have in Softr on the front end. And that looks exactly like this. If you've installed the template, you have this on your screen as well. So how do we start customizing the look and feel of this? As you can see right here, this is a very dark feel. Maybe my brand is light and happy. I've got very specific fonts, very specific colors that we use. I want my logo to be represented here. How can I get that into my application? Because if I were to first just preview the application as is, I can click on that preview button, and here's what opens up. This is my actual application right here, and this does not maybe represent my brand. Obviously projected here, this image and the rest of the components here on this page, this is all part of the template. I want to take ownership. So let's go ahead and hop out of the preview, get back into the actual building of the application. And on the left-hand side of our screen, we find the theme. And this, if we click on, we can open it up and see kind of the general settings for the branding, the look and feel of the application that we've built. So we can start by just reading the text block here that says, set the default styles and colors for all blocks. Now a block is a component inside of Softr. It's when we add a specific section for data or text or images. So by default, when we come into the themes, we are controlling all of the blocks. But I also want to highlight the very next part that it says, you can also manually change the style of each element and block when editing the block. So we're going to be controlling kind of the meta description, the meta settings for the application at large, but you can still go in block by block and update those settings further. So let's go ahead and affect the meta stuff, the whole application first. So what I'm going to do is first look at the base text size. Notice that I can update this information by making our text larger or smaller. Let's say that I want to bring this up to 18. Once I click save, we're going to refresh or reload the page. And of course, we're going to see much larger or slightly larger text on our blocks. Now, back to theme, I'm not going to reload every time. I can choose a different font. Maybe I want to go with a Roboto. And I can choose the weight of that font. So hairline all the way up to, you know, very bold. So whatever your brand looks like, of course, make that choice. And then you can bring in your heading color. Now for me, I have a very specific look and feel at our company Gap Consulting, and my color is this. So I can just use that hex code right here and drop that in. Now for the body font, because we were working on the heading. So here we come in for the body. I can update this, let's say to enter. The weight, I will move it up to medium as well. And we can choose the color here also. So I'm affecting the header with my first set of options and then the body here on the next set of options. So we have a lot of control at, again, the theme is controlling all of the settings across the application. I can also choose the roundness of my buttons if I want it to be slightly or more round. I can choose the text color for my buttons as well as the background color. So here's an example of a button inside of a block where it says add. And so if I want to update this, maybe I want all my buttons to be black for some reason. I can make that change here with the white text. No problem. Now, lastly, we also have the website width, and this is going to impact, obviously, the width of our overall application. Is it a fixed width, a full width, or a custom width? Let's update this one to full width. We've made a lot of changes now to the overall theme. Let's click save, and this is going to impact now everything, right? So text is bigger. We see new text colors. We see the button color is updated. We see the different color represented in our header text. We were able to impact all of the blocks just with controlling the theme of the application. But that's only the beginning, because now we might want to go in and adjust or update the information in our blocks on a more case-by-case basis. So right now I am on this project's list, and this is on a particular page, but we loaded a template. We have a number of different pages, and we have blocks, multiple blocks in some cases, on all of these pages. So let's flip over to the calendar, for example. Now we're going to see that the calendar was properly updated, right? So it has the same theme changes that we updated in the previous section. So I see the color and things of that nature, but maybe I want to update more about this block. I can click on that specific block and then come into styles. Styles is where we're going to affect the block specific controls. So I can update the padding for a particular block, for example. I can update the background color on a block. Let's bring a red in. So we see that all of this is updating in real time as I'm making those changes. Now I can add a border to the top. Let's go ahead and add a solid border here. And I will make it a rather thicker amount so that we can see that very slightly here at the top. And we can also do it to the bottom. We can add some border here as well. And we're going to see that black bar at the bottom. So actually, to make this a little bit more pronounced, I'm going to update it to white so that you can see that border at the top right there and not get it confused with the header. Now, the one block that is going to be present on every page is the header. And so if we actually click on the header, it's going to tell us here on the right hand side, we have to control the header by going to the home page. So we can just click right here, or we could have gone and navigated to our pages and found the home page. But the important thing to know is that we're going to update the header aesthetics from the home page. Now that I'm here at the home page, I can click on that. And again, over here on the right hand side of my page, that block opens up and we can go to styles and update the page, right? The header. So if I want to update the header to match my brand color, I can do so just like this. Let's go ahead and bring that down here. And just like that, it has been updated. Now, the other component here, of course, is this image, the projected image that they have right here. So I can go into features and I can update that image right here. So I can upload my own assets to my web applications, and I can even use the asset generator to do something from the AI bot here. So let's say Gap Consulting logo. Let's just see what the AI bot puts together for us. But this is a fantastic way for you, especially if you're working quickly, putting together a web application, to use this AI bot and get some good stuff. So here we go. I will just pull this asset in. It doesn't exactly look like what I want, but you get the idea. I can upload assets from my computer, generate them from AI, do all of this right here, and this is going to be affecting the entire application. So any other page that I go to now that shows the header, I'm going to see the updates that I made right there. Changing the colors, the fonts, all of those components is totally possible inside of Softr. In fact, I would argue that Softr, in terms of all the no-code tools out there that allow you to build your own custom web application, Softr has the greatest flexibility for you in terms of creating exactly the look and feel that you want for your web app. I know we went really fast in this video. I hope you got a ton of value from it. Of course, if you have a question about something we didn't quite cover, drop your questions below wherever you found the video. And in the meantime, keep on building.